When you're having a hard time getting pregnant, doesn't it seem like everybody around you is just getting pregnant? And if you get another invitation to a baby shower, you just want to explode. And everybody and their mother wants to give you advice on how they did it and how they got pregnant and how they were having a hard time. Sometimes you need to hear that advice from a medical professional. So what we're going to talk about today is my advice to you as a reproductive endocrinologist on how to maximize your success with your fertility journey and also with treatment. So it's really important for you to remember that there will be parts of this that are completely under your control, and there are going to be some parts that are going to be out of your control. So let's talk about the things that are in your control. Patients often ask me about diet. What can they eat? What can they avoid? What sort of foods might help improve or boost their fertility? We popularize pineapples as a way to boost your fertility, and something that a lot of patients do is eat pineapple core. And the truth is that if we knew pineapple can boost your fertility like that, I would have a pineapple stand in my waiting room and just sell pineapples all day long. But it's not as simple as that. What I do tell patients is that they should have a balanced diet. They shouldn't go on crash diets right before starting something as involved as IVF. And you can talk to your doctors about guidelines that their practice has around weight and what they would recommend for their patients. But for our patients, we want their body mass index to be less than 40. We want to also identify those areas in their lifestyle that might contribute to a lower egg quality. Things like alcohol is okay in moderation, and typically that is around no more than 5 drinks per week. But if you have more than 2 drinks a day, that's probably in excess, and we want to dial that back a little bit. Things like smoking. We really are very focused on making sure that any patients who are currently smokers, that they are completely done with smoking before starting the IVF process, because it does dramatically affect the quality of the eggs, the quality of the embryos and their embryo development, and we want them to be successful. We also have patients who ask a lot about stress. I always tell patients, no matter how they feel, it's not going to affect their overall outcomes with the IVF process. But I think the most important thing is that patients focus on self-care and making sure they're good to themselves, and allow yourself to have good days and bad days, and it's okay, and it won't affect your overall success rates with IVF. Patients find it very helpful as a complementary sort of approach to their treatment to seek ways of reducing stress, so things like yoga, exercise, but a lot of patients ask a lot about acupuncture, and acupuncture is a great way for patients to relieve their stress. It does improve blood flow to certain parts of the body. Alone is not what we would recommend as treating for infertility, but it is a very good way to help manage the stress as you go through the fertility journey and the treatment. We always recommend that patients who are trying to get pregnant are on a prenatal vitamin. Depending on the situation, we may recommend other things. So patients who have ovulatory issues, like polycystic ovarian syndrome, may benefit from an additional supplement called ovocetol to help their eggs metabolize the sugars better and help their eggs mature and grow, and that can overall help with egg function. We have some patients who maybe have lower ovarian reserve, and sometimes supplements like coenzyme can help improve the egg quality. And these supplements are readily available out there online. We would recommend going through some sort of supplement company that's FDA regulated, because what's on the box is what you're actually getting in the supplement. You could probably come up with a very quick list of about 24 other supplements that, you know, say that they treat things like recurrent pregnancy loss and help with sperm quality. For the most part, all those supplements have had very kind of mixed data, not ones that we would actually specifically recommend, but a lot of it's not harmful either. So I would suggest that if you're considering taking any of these supplements, talk to your doctor about what you're considering taking, because you don't want to start something without your doctor knowing, because it might interact with some of the medications that he's prescribing for your treatment. We're really lucky right now. In the generation before, infertility was still a very much a taboo subject, and very few people shared their stories or shared what they did to help themselves achieve the family that they have. Nowadays, it's so common to open up a conversation about it and start to hear from other sisters in the community who've gone through the fertility journey and through fertility treatment, have had their ups and downs, and not only are people willing to discuss it among their friends and family, but they're willing to share it on social media. So now we have access to a number of online sites for information. Patients can go to our website, but if they're looking for more, a little bit more of like crowdsourced information, we have a number of patient-driven social media sites, and these are becoming great sources of information for patients. They're also sharing about how they finance treatment, how they get grants and free money to afford treatment. Patients can find a lot of information on those online sources, but they can also get information from their doctors. And I think that it's really important that you have a good team on your side. You're with a practice, a physician, a nursing group, and a core support group that helps make you feel comfortable throughout the process. I always tell patients it's expect there to be bumps along the way, expect things to not go as planned, and but we want to make sure that our patients are positioned in a way that they'll have the most successful outcome and they felt as prepared as they could before they started.